So Christmas is coming up, and if I know you, you've probably got a gamer on your Christmas list, right? What to get them? You don't know what they have, what they don't have? But we're going to show you two games that should pique their interest.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey everybody, welcome to Tech Nick. I'm Nick Salvucci, and next to me is Jess Gilmore, as usual. And today we're going to be talking about two games. As you can see, we've got two games in our underneath our little Christmas tree. These are our little presents. Let's start with Black Ops, okay? We played Call of Duty Black Ops, and I thought it was awesome. What do you think, Jess?
I enjoyed it. A fan of Call of Duty in general ever since Modern Warfare, the first one. Just the whole the new game engine that they used to build it off of. Now this was comes from a different company than the Modern Warfare games.
I believe it's Treyarch.
Yeah, they went back to the other developer, and
switching off too. I've noticed that. And Treyarch only does they've done a lot of the World War II ones. This is their first foray into more modern.
Yeah, the first time they've gone into a new era in the warfare, and I think they pulled it off. I mean, I haven't got a chance to complete the campaign, but I have the multiplayer, which is what grabs me, and that's what I enjoy doing in these type of games. I enjoyed it, and along with the undead mode, the zombie mode, I really enjoy that aspect of the game. Yes.
Basically, what the game is about is you play CIA? I want to say he's obviously a government soldier working for the CIA. And it starts off in like 62, I believe, right? Most of the time you spend time in Vietnam a lot, but it's really cool. Like, there's a lot of, everything's all Cold War era weaponry. Personally, the storyline's really great. Like, it makes you feel like... the character physically does not know what happened. He has no idea what happened, and he's trying to regain his memory via interrogation the CIA. But it's pretty cool. But the biggest thing, obviously, everyone's going to ask about Call of Duty is the multiplayer.
Yes.
We have to answer questions about the multiplayer, of course. First off, like he said, zombie mode. You can play zombie mode with two people on one console, and...
You can online up to four, actually, that's pretty fun. Like, with the more people that you have, it adds to the experience. Because personally, I like playing with friends. I like system linking. I like getting a big group of people together and just playing, having
like
a good time. Yes, I don't like to be lonely. So, that's why I really enjoyed it. And, me being just a fan of Undead in general, really like that aspect of it and that playing of the game. It's the same... It is very similar to the one from the World at War.
Yes.
Because they had undead in that one, too. That's probably one of my favorite aspects of the game.
Jess and I got pretty far on Nazi zombies.
Not to brag or anything,
We're just really good at killing zombies.
But
later on you unlock 5, which is actually, it stands for DEFCON 5, because actually what happens after you beat the campaign, you get to start off, and what happens is... You play either John F. Kennedy, William McNamara, Fidel Castro, or Richard Nixon, and you fight off zombies while in the Pentagon. And it's actually really cool.
Yeah.
And the cool thing about this is, you just have to upgrade it, and you just have to unlock it by gaining levels, and then you upgrade. And then one of the cool things about it is, I believe the camouflage for guns, you can unlock all of it at the same time, I think. I personally haven't gotten that far to unlock it all completely. But I think it's just like that, and then you can put emblems like your little tag is. You can even put words on there. Like if you've seen the trailer, actually, we'll show the trailer right now.
But right now we're in a phase in gaming where customization is key. Like, everybody wants a lot of customization. They want to be able to create their own character
Which you can with this. Not to the extent where I had originally heard, but not to the extent where I have to change my own, who I look like. You can change face paint, but speaking of character creation, let's move on. But first, let's give a little. What would you give Call of Duty Black Ops?
Four to five.
I give it a 4.5. I mean, I liked it. Some stuff could have been way better. I would have liked to have more customization, but the missions on this thing, the storyline, it's great. I would suggest buying it. If any of the kids on your list are fans of Call of Duty or anything like that, then definitely for sure go get it. So now let's move on to our second game, Fallout New Vegas. Let's take a look at the trailer right now.
Changes.
I played it, Fallout New Vegas. I played it the same, probably less than Fallout 3, and I got the same feel to it. It's like after you get patched up by the doctor, how you start a thing. I walked out into this empty world, which obviously it's apocalypse, post-nuclear. But I don't know. It just didn't feel.
I don't know if you can really call Nevada post-apocalypse. I mean, you are in the middle of the desert. I mean.
Yeah,
how bad can a desert really get?
It's clearly post-apocalyptic. Mm-hmm. And, you know, for me, being a big fan of Oblivion, this is why I was disappointed with Fallout 3, is I loved Oblivion.
Yeah, I love Oblivion too. I'm a big fan
of Fallout 3, and I'm thinking, oh, you know, Oblivion with guns.
Yeah.
And I was thoroughly disappointed. And same with this one. I mean, I walk into the character customization, and I wasn't disappointed with that, but I've seen better.
I agree. There wasn't really that much change from Fallout 3. The biggest thing I realized during the game was, in Fallout 3, there are guys who give you haircuts, and they can change your beard and stuff like that. There is nobody at all that can change your facial features.
And you think that, you know, with Vegas, New Vegas, you know.
It's Vegas, I'm sure.
One thing I did like, though, the perk for the crazy
Wild Wasteland.
Wild Wasteland's
pretty fun.
Did like that.
It's
that
a perk
fun.
You can choose. Like most games, you know, Fallout 3 had its own, you know, whole set of like, you know, little in tongue in cheek jokes. New Vegas has that too. Biggest thing about New Vegas was they have a perk at the beginning of the game where you can. It's called Wild Wasteland, where you can literally say, I want everything stupid to happen to me. So Jess actually ran into a little inside joke. You want to tell him that one?
Yeah, no. The first one that I found, I loved it. I don't know if all of you have watched the newest Indiana Jones movie, but how he gets into the lead-lined
fridge
refrigerator and gets blown up. Well, in this one, he doesn't live. I found a fridge with a person in it with Indiana Jones' hat. So, and that just made me crack up. That was probably my favorite, and the only part about the game that I really liked, honestly.
Well, I mean, yeah, the storyline's really good, I think.
I didn't get that far. I didn't get far enough into it where I can really judge it.
I mean,
I'm just judging it on gameplay.
I don't know how far you did. You get to Vegas at all?
No, I did not.
Okay. When I first played this and I got to the New Vegas, what happened was, as soon as I got in, I was like, all right, cool, this is gonna be great. I get in and like the lights blind your character, so it kind of fades in from white, and the first thing I hear is Dean Martin's "Ain't That a Kick in the Head." There's drunk people walking all over. In fact, the first time I went through there, NCR is one of the groups. NCR soldier gets so drunk, he leans over, grabs onto the sign for a casino, and vomits over onto the sign and the ground. It's just like real Las Vegas, just in the future. And there's only four main casinos. There is the casino called Gamora. Their tagline is Gamora. Let's just keep this between us. Then there's the Tops, which is kind of like it seems like it was built by the Rat Pack, you know, Frank Sinatra and all that. Everybody's like, hey baby, how's it going? You know, all that stuff. Then there's the Ultra Lux, which is really creepy, sterile, and weird, kind of like ultra fancy. And the last one is the Lucky 38, which is built like a roulette wheel. But you know, it, all in all, I mean, it is. It almost does kind of. I have to give you that. It feels like it's a branch off of original Fallout. But however, I feel better about this because it actually connects. I used to play the old Fallouts 1 and 2, and this literally like pulled me right back into exactly what was going on at that time.
Yeah.
So I mean, I like it. I mean, it does. I will say it does feel like.
Yeah. Yeah. Just personally, so far I don't like it. That's all I'm gonna say. I mean. And I'm one of the few. A lot of people love the Fallout games. They love Fallout 3, and I did not. That reminds me
of the biggest thing we have to talk about Fallout 3. The glitches. A lot of bugs. I mean, normally there's some bugs, you know, like people falling through maps, stuff like that. I've heard of that before. Biggest one, I can't give this one a completely great number of a grade here, because what happened to me is the first time I played through, I got quite far. Until one day it decided that it didn't want to load both save files at that point. It froze in the middle of loading. And that really gave me... I really was so mad about that. It was, like, the most stupidest thing I've ever seen in my entire life for a game to do. And so, I think for Fallout New Vegas, I love it, but I'm going to give it probably a 2.8. Yeah, it almost made 3, but...
I don't even feel comfortable giving it a rating at this point. I mean, I haven't given it a fair chance, but so far I wouldn't like it. I'd probably give it a 1.
Alright. So, you know... It's an alright game. It's good. It's really, everybody was looking forward to it, but it needs to be fixed. And hopefully they get some patches through and some new, and there's, I know for a fact there's DLC coming for it.
Yeah, of course.
It's downloadable content for all you non-gamers out there. So hopefully that'll make it a lot better, and then we'll get some patches on there making it a lot better for us. So from now on, stick with Call of Duty Black Ops for now. So this has been Tech Nick. I have been Nick Salvucci.
I've been Jesse Gilmore for this one.
And for this one. So hopefully you have a happy holidays, and maybe you should buy some of these for your kids. All right, so I'll catch you later.
Bye.